Okay. Really? Okay.
496. Les tensions s'exacerbent sur le plateau et Marilyn commence à perdre le soutien d'une équipe qui jusqu'ici l'appuyait. Mais tout le monde allait lui pardonner quand on sut qu'elle tournerait nue la scène de la piscine le 23 mai. Une grande première, aucune star américaine ne l'avait encore osé.
Come on in. The water is so refreshing.
Where was that panic?
C'était la panique, une atmosphère électrique. Les gens couraient dans tous les sens.
Tout le monde fut chassé du plateau, y compris moi. Jamais je n'avais été interdit de plateau avec Q-Core. Mais Marilyn ne voulait personne.
La scène devait donner seulement l'illusion d'un bain de minuit. Mais Marilyn poussa les choses plus loin.
On avait un maillot de bain pour qu'elle semble nue sous l'eau. Mais après deux ou trois prises, elle l'a retiré. Et elle a tout fait totalement nue.
En posant nue avec provocation sur le bord de la piscine, Marilyn fait savoir au monde entier qu'elle possède encore un corps sublime. L'actrice semble très inspirée par la scène et par la présence de ses photographes de plateau favoris. Une fois encore, elle se donne à des objectifs amoureux depuis des années de son visage et de son corps.
Quand ce fut terminé, elle m'a dit « Elizabeth Taylor ne sera plus en couverture des magazines ». Et effectivement, c'est ce qui s'est passé.
La Fox avait retrouvé de l'optimisme, la scène était extraordinaire. Et Monroe avait été présente une semaine entière sans interruption. En quittant le studio le vendredi 25 mai, Marilyn semblait heureuse comme elle ne l'avait jamais été depuis des semaines. Le jour suivant, on tourne cette scène où le mari, Nick Arden, sous-entend que sa femme Hélène lui a été infidèle pendant son absence. Sur le plateau, Marilyn est peu concentrée.
All right, Kim.
Adam and Eve.
I was afraid you'd misunderstand about that.
Oh, what's to misunderstand? A man's wife spends 5 years on an island with a strange man.
Would you like it any better if I knew him?
And it slips her mind?
Can we start again?
Yeah.
All you can think about is the way I behaved with this poor little... Okay.
With this poor little fly.
All you can think of is how I behaved with a very... A poor little man who wouldn't harm a fly.
Yeah, one more. That was good, though, huh?
I mean, how long does it take to tell a woman, my wife's back? It takes me 2 seconds. It's taken... You've had 2 days. Sorry, George, but we can do it.
Get back in.
Come on, the water's so refreshing.
You know, after you finish doing, you know.
Nicholas!
Coming, honey. Right there.
Nicholas!
Oh, no, dear, didn't... There's a draft out there.
Sit down here. Just catch cold.
This on.
How are you? Mr. Arden, I'm sorry to disturb you at this hour of the night. I'm Johnson of the American Life and Accident Assurance Company.
Come right in. I need all the insurance I can get.
Well, thank you.
Oh, right up here.
You know, I did have the privilege of meeting you at a Dent Father's pack night some months ago.
Oh, yes, how could I? Upstairs, we'll have a drink.
Oh, no, I don't drink, but you go right ahead.
All right.
Say, I hope you'll forgive me for getting you out of bed.
Oh, I'm glad you came.
My, you have a lovely place here.
Oh, you like it?
I hope you've got everything covered.
Completely.
Swimming at this hour?
Oh, we're an outdoor family.
Oh, my, listen to that splashing. Must be doing the breaststroke. Yeah. I hope the pool is heated.
It's being heated right now.
Now, Mr. Arden, have you received any communication from your first wife, Ellen Wagstaff Arden?
What?
I mean, any letters, telephone calls, telegrams? No, just as I thought. Oh, our district manager, Mr. Fowler. He's such a fuss budget. He wants to check everything. Of course, it's customary for a company to check when they put out a large sum of money. But this is so ridiculous.
What are you talking about?
Well, they have a report, actually a rumor, that a woman answering the general description of your first wife was picked up by an American submarine.
Well, to tell you the truth,
A young man answering the general description of Stephen Burkett, who's reported drowned the same time your wife was. Oh, it's absurd.
Would you say that again, please?
Oh, it's really not worth repeating.
A man was rescued at the same time as my wife?
A young man, according to this unverified rumor.
They're on this island together for 5 years.
Ridiculous, isn't it?
What else did your district manager hear?
Well, nothing, really, but it seems that he talked to someone who talked to someone else who spoke to one of the sailors. Well, I have it here. The sailor said the woman called the man Adam.
Adam?
A far cry from Stephen. Oh, it's just too absurd.
What did he call her?
Eve.
Eve?
Adam and Eve. Oh, a delightful fancy.
A delight.
Well, I guess I'll run along now. And thank you so much, Mr. Arden. I'm sorry to have troubled you at this hour. But that Fowler, he does get my dander up. He never admits he's wrong. Well, I can't wait to see the expression on his face. Don't bother. I know my way out. Oh, do you mind? No, go. Thank you. Adam and Eve.
Enjoy your swim?
I always used to take a moonlight swim on the island.
With Adam?
Adam?
Did you always take a moonlight swim on the island with Adam, Eve?
Oh.
Adam and Eve.
I was afraid you'd misunderstand about that.
Oh, what's to misunderstand? A man's wife spends 5 years on an island with a strange man.
Would you like it any better if I knew it?
And it slips her mind?
Well, I was going to tell you, but I know how upset you get about little things.
Little things?
First of all, you misunderstand. You see, he was trying to get the boat through the surf. He broke his leg. He was laid up for 6 months.
6 months? That still leaves 4.5 years.
All you can think about is the way I behaved with a poor little man who wouldn't harm a fly. Why don't you think about telling her that your wife's back? No, that wouldn't occur to you, would it?
I was going to tell her. I
mean, how long does it take a man to tell a woman that his wife's back? That his wife's back?
Shh.
It takes 2 seconds. I just did it in 2 seconds. You've had 2 days.
Don't change the subject.
Oh, any excuse for storm. That's why you're picking on Adam. If only you could see Adam. Gentle, harmless Adam.
I'd like to see him. I'd like to thank him for all he did for you.
I've already done that.
I want him to know how grateful I am.
I told him I knew you'd be.
Where's he now?
The YMCA.
YMCA?
Yes, he lives at the YMCA, and he loves it at the YMCA. What else do you want to know? Satisfied?
Completely.
Now, aren't you ashamed of those suspicions you had about me?
Terribly.
Cut it, Gordon. Thank you.
Cut.